Chola's Empire. Now let us have a brief look on the Chola's Empire. The heartland of the Cholas was the fertile valley of the Kaveri River, but they ruled a significantly larger area at the height of their power from the later half of the 19th century till the beginning of the 13th century. The whole country south of the Tungabhadra was united and held as one state for a period of two centuries and more. Under Rajaraja Chola I and his successors Rajendra Chola I, Rajadhiraja Chola, Veera Rajendra Chola and Kulutunga Chola I, the dynasty became a military, economic and cultural power in South and Southeast Asia. Now we will see the role of Cholas. The Cholas left a lasting legacy. Their patronage of Tamil literature and their zeal in the building of temples has resulted in some great works of Tamil literature and architecture. The Chola kings were avid builders and envisioned the temples in their kingdoms not only as places of worship, but also as centers of economic activity. They pioneered a centralized form of government and established a disciplined bureaucracy. The Chola school of art spread to Southeast Asia and influenced the architecture and art of Southeast Asia. Also, according to the Malay Chronicle, Sajare Melayu, the rulers of the Sultanate claimed to be descendants of the kings of the Chola Empire. Now students, look at the history. The history of the Cholas falls into four periods. The early Cholas of the Sangam literature, the interregnum between the fall of Sangam Cholas and the rise of the medieval Cholas under Vijayalaya, circa 848, the dynasty of Vijayalaya, and finally the later Chola dynasty of Kolutunga Chola I from the third quarter of the 11th century. Medieval Cholas. While there is little reliable information on the Cholas during the period between the early Cholas and Vijayalaya dynasties, there is an abundance of materials from diverse sources on the Vijayalaya and the later Chola dynasties. A large number of stone inscriptions by the Cholas themselves and by their rival kings, Pandyas and Chalukyas, and copperplate grants have been instrumental in constructing the history of Cholas of that period. Vijayalaya, a feudatory of Pallavas, took an opportunity arising out of a conflict between Pandyas and Pallavas in circa 850, captured Thanjavur from Mudaliar. Now, the later Cholas. The later Chola dynasty saw capable rulers in Kulutunga Chola I, his son Vikrama Chola, other successors like Rajaraja Chola II, Rajadhiraja Chola II, and the great Kulutunga Chola III, who conquered Kalinga, Elam, and Kataha. However, the rule of the later Cholas between 1218, starting with Rajaraja Chola II, to the last emperor Rajendra Chola III, was not strong as those of the emperors between 850 to 1215. Around 1118, they lost control of Vengi to the western Chalukya and Gangavadi, southern Mysore districts to the Hoysala Empire.